Aloha, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler, along with Dick Vitale, and welcome to the beautiful island of Maui for this first round game of the EA Sports Maui Invitational Tournament between the Idaho Vandals and the Princeton Tigers. Dick, you've been in this situation as a coach. What do you tell your team when it looks like a mismatch on paper?
I tell you what, it looks like a David versus Goliath, baby, but you never know. Could be upset city if they protect the basketball. You know what? I think it's essential they control the tempo of the game.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. The Tigers are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Yeah, on a night like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. Number one, make sure you take care of the rock. Turnovers kill momentum. Secondly, don't let your man beat you to the rebound. Third, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Try to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's fluffing, baby.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. The good rebounding position, a good block out, and that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
Number four takes the pass. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Ball goes out of play. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Got a man in high post. He's got to get rid of it.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake and good footwork, keeping his pivot foot down.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Working around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. Off the rim and no good. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Looking for a good shot. The shooting guard gets the pass. Jumps into the defender.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. That's going to be a 5-second call. Credit that to the defense. Sideline inbounds. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Gave it up. Goes for the deep one. Makes the shot. He can't stay with it.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
They look to get it to the inside. He looks at the hoop. Down he goes and no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
He shoots from long range. Way off target.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The point guard gets the ball.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Knocks it down. Number 22 takes the feed. He nails the shot. Trying to feed inside.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well.
Moving it around the perimeter. Here's the three ball. Off the rim and no good. There's a high screen. Doesn't go. Keeps the dribble as they regroup.
Dump it inside.
Tries for two, and he scores it off the glass.
Dump it inside. Trying to go inside.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Perfectly executed. Momentary look from three-point land. From left of the circle, way off target.
I think right now, gotta focus defensively.
Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. The lane. You better plug your ears if they get a basket on this possession. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The crowd is enjoying this close one. The fans are just waiting for the favorites to pull away. But will it happen here tonight?
All right, thanks, Aaron.
I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. Pushes it up. The shooting guard with the ball for the bucket. And he missed. It in. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Blocks the shot. Gets the ball and out faces his man down on the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up, blocks the shot. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Doesn't go. And he scores despite the hat.
Let's take another look.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
For three. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
They work it around the perimeter. Number 12 draws the personal. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Number 12 goes to the charity stripe. First one, good. Misses the free one. He cleans the glass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Working it around the perimeter. And working around the arc.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. Ooh, look at a shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Puts it up, looking for contact. Idaho is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Puts it on the floor and up and under. The Tigers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Two for one opportunity. Here's a double team. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler and he lost it.
Gets it back out. Gave it up. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
All right, let's check in. Third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
From right out of the circle, drains it. At the half, the Tigers lead by six. Now let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. Princeton gave us a three-ball lesson, Dick, in that first half.
I'll tell you, a mighty lesson it was. I expect to see more of the same in the second half.
This is kind of what we expected, Richard. You know, going into this ball game, we didn't expect it to be close in the first half, and it wasn't.
They're really going to have to really, really regroup and come out with some fire and get some momentum. It's essential they go on a spurt to get some confidence. If they don't get a spurt, hey, Brad, you got all your material ready? Because we're going to have to hit and talk about everything, baseball, basketball, football. Hey, who's going to win the Super Bowl?
Number four picks up the foul. First team foul.
This is what posters are made from.
He is going to the line. Hits that one. The pick comes back to haunt the screener that time. Takes the pass in the paint. The ball goes out of bounds. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Jumped in front to take it away.
This is swarming defense.
The small forward handles the feed. He's money with a shot. Defense. There's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. Looking for a good shot. Picked out of the air. Number 35 is charged with the foul. Nick, he's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Number 12 is called for the foul. First personal foul.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
There they come with a double team to stop it. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. What should they do here, Dick?
I'm calling a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He launches a three. Goes.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense. Poor job defensively. Don't get back. Don't stop the ball. And they were allowed to convert. Get the number game going.
Let's watch the move as he works his man and not a fadeaway jumper.
Let's go back and watch that basket again.
The dribble, gives it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Fronts in first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Jumps in with a layup. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Gave it up in the paint. He fakes the shot. From the top of the circle.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Let's it fly. Oh, yes. The Tigers are up by 12. Picks off the lazy pass. And Dick, this is just playing good defense and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. On the dribble, gives it up. Picks off the pass. They work it around the perimeter. Number 24 is fired up right now, emotional.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
With a little baby hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
On the outside. He pulls the trigger.
He kept his dribble and ran the defender right off the screen for a beautiful jump shot, Brad.
Gave it up. Steals the pass. Tries for two. And off the mark. Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in man.
Lets it fly. Brings the shot. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as expected, the favorite has led the way through most of this one, and that's what happens when you have the makeup of a great team.
And he'll kick it back outside. From downtown, off the rim and no good. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Looking for contact with the layup. In the paint.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He drains the bucket. Moving it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Number 22 is pounded on his way up. Okay, Dick, some people were predicting this. The players are starting to taunt one another. Number 24 gets in on his first minutes tonight.
Hey, this kid really knows how to keep the offense moving. Tremendous leader out there.
First shot, good. Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Fans will be celebrating tonight, Dick. This one's out of reach.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
For two, they still don't score. Picked off. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Gives it up.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Big man spins down on the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other. Look at that spacing.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He looks for the bomb. Tickles the twine. He attempts the three. Knocks it down. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
There might be a change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
Looking for a good shot. Outside jumper. Rims out. Looking for a good shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Gave it up. He tries the three. Off the rim and no good. Shot clock is dead. The shooting guard gets the ball. Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
The center handles the pass. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
Well, Dick, this is unbelievable. I didn't expect this. I think they should have won, and they couldn't find a way to get anything done tonight.
Yeah, they really want to get to the locker room, post the W, and move on. And they do it because, number one, they're unselfish. They share the rock, baby. They know how to give it up. They always make that one extra pass that leads to that extra good shot.
State Farm drive of the game.
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
Princeton comes away with a huge win tonight in this blowout.
With the difference in these two teams' rankings, the win was pretty much a foregone conclusion.